Sometimes a page is really, really long. And a lot of times we want something to animate only as that something is in view. In other words, we only want this animation to animate while we can see it. So in this example, we're going to have three sections. The first and last sections will take up 300% of the viewport height. They're set to 300 VH. Why such a ridiculously long number? Because we want to simulate a really long page. And the middle section, it's set to only 100% of the viewport height. So we'll cover this in three parts. We'll drag in our Lottie asset, we'll set up the scroll-based trigger, and finally, we'll configure the animation. Let's start with the asset. First things first, from our assets panel, let's drag in the animation. Then we'll place it in our middle section, the second of the three sections. Okay, that's part one. Part two is setting up the trigger. Over in interactions, let's make sure our animation is selected, and our goal is to have this animation happen as we scroll, while the element is in view. So we'll select that option. That's part two. Part three is where we turn this thing into a reality. Let's add an animation. And in that animation, let's add our first action. This is like a keyframe. When the animation is 0% scrolled into view, we want to hold right at the beginning of the Lottie animation. 0% is where the animation begins. But at 100%, by the time the Lottie animation has scrolled past our screen, out of view, this is where we want the animation to reach the end. And once we've done that, we can turn on live preview or go over to preview mode, and the animation progresses as it's scrolling in view. Now, the pattern here with After Effects and Lottie is pretty straightforward. Drop in the Lottie asset, set up your trigger, and configure the animation. But that's a scroll-based Lottie animation in the Webflow Designer.